to my auntie and my husband. I can give nothing but love to the stars and full of life, to the ones sent from up above. Thank you for the kindness, for everything you do. Thank you for the happiness. Thanks for seeing me through. I love you more than anything. I will love you to the end. You are my mother first and then my very best friend. It is unusual what we share. Everything I do, you know. Every beautiful quality you have in me, I try to show. Not often enough do I tell you how much you mean to me. Not often enough do I show you how your love set me free. To live forever and always is what I wish for you. A long life everlasting for one so sacred and true. You are my special angel, who I will always find comfort in, whether life is in a shamble, whether I lose or whether I win. To the one who gave me life, I can give nothing but love. To the one who genuinely is sent from heaven to earth.
Me and Marlon, we should hit the club. Thank God for Jesus, I am saved. I remember the stories, I remember the accolades. And I thank her for that. I thank her for that. I love God so much. I hate to believe on these circumstances, but God has a way of bringing family back to family. He knows what's best for all of us.
I want to thank Mama for you guys. I want to thank you guys for Mama, especially because I'm not really close to my family. You guys can see that during the holidays. I'm not an official Abba family, but you guys still want to come to this one. All of you. The
The thing I can say with family and with the citizens,
Marlo's here.
Yes.
We always were able to come to a safe place. And Ms. Elsie's house was that place.
Right.
And so, for me, she's going home to a great place.
Right.
Heaven is the ultimate appointment.
Yes.
That there's no pain, there's no suffering, there's no arguing, there's no fussing. Just able to be joyous and be happy. And she's looking down on us now and telling us, be happy, remember the things she instilled in us to be men and women. Let's carry that to our grandchildren and so forth.
And then Mama's teaching
like Lydia said, she's not the problem, to make some things a little bit clearer to her. Mama did that with me as well. And then Mama teaching me, taught me how to teach my own, how to read God's word, study God's word, so that I can share God's word with mine. And then raising my grandchildren, when Mama passed away the other day, my little youngest granddaughter said to me, all of us were breaking down. And my little granddaughter said, Grandma Don, you mean she already in heaven? She already got her castle made out of diamonds? Right? I almost passed. And everybody goes, I stopped her. I said, that's right then. Hold on. She already know what Jesus looks like. She know what the pearly gates look like. She know what that water look like. It's got that, it look like a diamond or some kind of stone that but don't know me and know. But it took the teaching them up, teaching that we all have a castle in heaven with our names on. But when my granddaughter remembered the word of God, from hearing the things that she was taught, she remembered and she put us all back on the ground. We were like, okay. Tomorrow you will pray. He said, my grandma said, my big mom said she rewrote the Bible. She rewrote the Bible. Yes, she did. And now she up there with God. She doing what God do. But what my mother did, those was pray for us. And when she passed, I said, Lord, I know you know what you're doing. You don't make mistakes. And you said, something good comes to the perfect study. The scripture goes, if something good comes to those who love the Lord and are called by his name. And I said, Lord, what's the good in this? I said, Lord, I don't know what's the good. What is the good in this? I said, Lord, I love you, Lord. What's the good in this? And then when I got to see it, all of my family coming together, the family that was estranged, the family that was mad, the family that wasn't talking, the loved ones and the friends that we've known and haven't talked to, the good of them that love the Lord. Mama brought us all together for the good. She died for a good thing. She moved away so that we could all come together and love one another like she loved us. Because Mama loved us.
Amen.
And Mama loved each and every one of you. Mama always had a smile on her face. She always had a word of encouragement. And she always had something to tell you, a tidbit. Pastor always refers to one of his mentors as a man that always loved him. Nuggets of wisdom. Mama used to drop nut every day. She would drop a boulder, then she would drop a mountain into your life. Something that she would tell you that would be so profound. You'll always remember. Mama told me that. I remember that. Mama said that. And then she used to always say, one of these days we're going to say Mama told me that. Mm-hmm. And then beat you. Mama took us to church and pinched us before we were making noise. But Mama loved us. And Mama is so happy because I know she sees us now. And she knows that we are together. And all she ever wanted us to do was love one another. And be together. Amen.
Amen. Amen. I never saw her unpacked. She was always like she was on her way to Hollywood to meet. I remember seeing this lady that had this full head of beautiful black hair and these long fingernails. Like, I got this. And her placed me across her lap because we were out playing after it was dark. She had come to Mississippi where my mom and I were. And we were in the back of my Ida's house, her only sister. And I had gotten hurt, but she wasn't satisfied with me saying that I was okay. She took me and she pulled on my shirt. She looked at me and she looked at my hands and my arms and kissed all my boo-boos. And then she laid me across her lap and looked at my booty. I mean, I don't know, but that's what a grandma does. You know, they're not satisfied with, when we say we're okay. It's their job to go above and beyond. And my grandmother did that because she was a matriarch to many. She was a mother to many, and she will be very well missed, you know. And a lot of the good that's within me came from her. And I look at this front row, and I see my grandma sitting in the middle of the room. And, she's multi-talented. And as I said, she left a legacy of laughter, love and longevity, and I just want to share that with everybody else who was, is irreplaceable and very unique, to say the least.